Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. We're now going to focus on integration in proton NMR. In NMR, if a peak arises from multiple identical hydrogens, then the peak will be larger in terms of the area beneath the signal of the peak. Let's look at ethyl ether. A common solvent. This molecule has two different types of hydrogens. The first type consists of the four hydrogens in the two identical CH2 groups. The second type consists of the six hydrogens in the two identical CH3 groups. If we look at the NMR spectrum from nmrdb.org, we see numbers above the two NMR signals. The signal around 3.4 ppm has a 4.0 to indicate four hydrogens. There are four hydrogens from the two CH2 groups. This signal is farther downfield because the electronegative oxygen is deshielding the hydrogens on carbon. The signal at around 1.2 ppm is six hydrogens, 6.0 above the peak. These are the six hydrogens from the CH3 groups. If we could accurately measure the area below these curves for the two peaks, we would find that the two areas have a ratio of 4 to 6, the same as the numbers over the peaks. While NMRDB knows the chemical structure and the exact number of hydrogens that cause each signal, if you are taking an NMR of an unknown molecule, you may not have any idea what the number should be. In this case, it's very common to arbitrarily assign the smallest peak to an integration value of 1. All the other peaks will have integrations that are proportionally larger. For ethyl ether, if we set the smaller peak as 1, that's this peak over here, 1, make it 1.0, then the larger peak would be 1.5. 1.0 to 1.5 is the same ratio as 4 to 6. Technically, integration gives us the ratio between the area for two signals. It does not tell us the number of hydrogens. It's only with additional knowledge that you can use the ratio to determine the exact number of hydrogens in each signal. In the case of ethyl ether, with the 1.0 to 1.5 ratio, we know that you cannot have half a hydrogen. At a minimum, we would need to multiply our ratio values by 2 to get a 2-to-3 ratio. Once we understand that the molecule is symmetrical, we can double the values again to get to 4-to-6. Integration values are very, very useful. Students who are first learning NMR often ignore integrations in favor of chemical shifts and multiplicity, but integrations are just as informative.